When we're looking at a match, is that going to make a difference? The fact that me and my brothers are descended from our father and my cousin is descended from his mother, and that's our common joining bond between them. In a previous video, I compared some matches to myself, my brothers, and a cousin. Now, one viewer was rather astute and saw that my cousin was the son of my aunt, whereas me and my brothers are the sons of our father. In other words, my father and aunt are siblings. They wanted to know whether or not that sex difference mattered as far as matches. We know that maternal chromosomes have 1.76 times the number of recombinations as paternal chromosomes. For instance, you get a set of chromosomes from your father, and you get a set of chromosomes from your mother. The set of chromosomes that you get from your father have less recombinations on average than the set of chromosomes that you get from your mother. In other words, your mother's chromosomes are divided up into more segments of each of her parents than your father's chromosomes are divided up of his parents. When we're looking at a match, is that going to make a difference? The fact that me and my brothers are descended from our father and my cousin is descended from his mother, and that's our common joining bond between them. Does that make a difference in the match? And so I thought about this before I went and took a look at anything to come up with my hypothesis of what I think is going to happen. First off, the total amount of shared centimorgans should not matter, because even though my cousin's chromosomes are going to be more segmented than my chromosomes and my brother's chromosomes, the amount of DNA shared on average should still be the same. So we shouldn't see a difference with that. The matches through the maternal chromosome, so in other words, the matches with my cousin, they should have more segments because his is going to be more segmented. And so you would then conclude then that they should have more segments. Even though the total number of chromosomes is the same, they should have more segments. And that then, of course, leads to the third thing, that the matches through the maternal chromosome should have smaller centimorgans per segment, because you have the same amount of centimorgans, but we have more segments, so that number is going to be smaller. So after I got that in my mind, I figured, okay, what can I do to test this now? I took me and I compared myself, I think, to 25 different matches. And I took my cousin and I compared him to the same 25 matches. So mine represent the paternal chromosomes. His represent the maternal chromosomes. Mine should be the less segmented. His should be the more segmented. And I averaged the difference between the total centimorgans of mine and the total centimorgans of his. If I was correct, I should expect this number to be zero, because there's going to be some where I share more than he does and others where he shares more than I do. Overall, it should be about zero. Well, my results from this were actually the difference was about 30 centimorgans on average that I shared more than him. And I expected this to be close to zero. And I thought, okay, that is odd. So let me try something different to see if this is just an outlier. So what I did then is I looked at me and one of my brothers. So again, we're both paternal, represent paternal chromosomes. But again, just because of the randomness of DNA, we should be close to zero as far as the average difference between it. Some will be more, some will be less. But it turned out it was about the same as what it was between me and my cousin, about 31 centimorgans positive difference. In other words, I shared more centimorgans than my brother even, and about the same amount, slightly more than what I shared with my cousin with these matches. So that was the first little puzzling thing. I'm thinking, okay, well, maybe I've got something wrong in my thinking as far as why this is or how this is. So I went on to the next one, and that is the difference in segments. Now, again, my cousin should have more segments. And since I'm subtracting his from mine, I should have a negative number as far as the number of segments we share with each one of these matches. It turns out, no, I ended up actually with a positive number, 0.7. So in other words, I almost, on average, had one more segment than him for each one of these matches. This, again, was puzzling to me. And so I thought, well, let me check with my brother again. And that was even more, 1.2, but it should have been close to zero because me and my brother represent the same paternal set of chromosomes. And yet I end up with more segments than him. And so at this point, I was really thinking, huh, this might actually be more of the randomness of DNA. So let me go on to the last one, the centimorgans per segment average. Now on this, I was expecting his to be smaller number, but not as close as what the results were. In other words, I have a paternal of 23.5 and a maternal, his, of 20.5. Now, since on average maternals have 1.76 times more recombinations, I actually expected this number to be significantly less, probably in the neighborhood of 15 or so. And so guess what? I checked with my brother also. Well, my brother, who again represents paternal, he only had a 21 centimorgan per segment average. So it was actually really close to my cousin. And at this point, I just had to say, well, wait a second. Why was I wrong about everything? I had come up with three things that I thought would happen because of this one piece of knowledge we do know. 1.76 times maternal recombinations of maternal. That has been verified by experiments, multiple different people, including my own, with different ways of calculating it, of gathering that data. That's really not a question. But from that, my three hypotheses were completely wrong. Not even close to right, I would guess what I would say. So why was that? And as I went back and I looked at this chart, it actually became rather obvious why. And so let me show you. I have this one path here. And of course, it's going through my father, so it is a paternal recombination. My cousin has this path here. It's going through his mother, so that is a maternal recombination. But one of the things we don't know with each of these matches is it going this way or is it going this way? Because that would make a difference. In this case, if it was going through his mother, well, then on average, they should be about 1.76 over here. And with me and my father, it should be about 1.35. So not quite as big of a disparity, right? And if it was going through the father, again, same thing. Mine would stay at about 1.0, and this would go to about 1.35. But as we see here, the other thing that we don't know is this going through my grandmother or is this going through my grandfather? In this case, the route really matters because once again, we also don't know which route this is taking through the mother or father. And in general, over time, when we're looking at these matches, you have this big loop of things, which is going through something that is 1.7 times or one times, 1.7 times or one times. In general, you're going to get to the point where they're just about average. And if you have, you know, let's say five, six of these paths that you actually are able to finally map out, you'll find that there's really only one difference in it. And that is this one right here. But because all the others have averaged out, you're actually not going to see that much difference. And what's going to happen is the randomness of DNA takes over. So when I say the randomness of DNA, just because on average, maternal chromosomes have 1.76 times the number of recombinations as a paternal chromosome, does not mean every maternal chromosome has 1.76 times a paternal chromosome. In fact, there are some paternal chromosomes that have more recombinations than maternal chromosomes. It's not often, but it happens. And so in this case, because we're dealing with lots of different recombinations and generations to get to these matches, you really have to fall back on the randomness of the DNA. So what I learned from myself from this is I may be right, but my experiment that I set up was not designed properly and did not take into account the different variables that there were for this. And I think that's an important lesson to learn when we're thinking about doing our research and testing out a theory, is just because we think we got it right, we need to always take a step back and see whether or not all of the data fits that, and whether we have accounted for all of the variables that can affect that. And in this case, I didn't. And so I was wrong. Maybe. I'm going to actually have to think about whether or not I could design an experiment with the information that I have that would be able to show whether those three things I mentioned at the beginning are correct. But for right now, I'm going to have to answer our viewer's question of whether or not the sex of the parent makes a difference in the amount of shared CM that you have with a match is, I don't know. I've not been able to put together an experiment to show whether or not it does. So that's an open question. I may come back and revisit that later if I can come up with something that will give me some definitive answer. Now, if you like this video and you would like to learn something more about DNA, then check out this video up here. And be sure to like the video and subscribe to our channel.